Hi YouTube. In this video tutorial, I will show how to program Arduino to communicate with the Scilab and take data over the USB serial port. Actually, my data will be the temperature of my room, and I use an Arduino Uno and a TMP36 temperature sensor. And my goal is to push that button and take the measurement over here, and I also want to have a real time data plot. My data plot is the 3000 last measurements, and that is my goal. Let's see how we program the Arduino, the Scilab, to implement that. First of all, let's speak a little for the Arduino code. At that line, we open the serial communication, and these lines are used to convert the temperature reading to Celsius degrees, and after that we convert that float number as a string, and we send the string over the USB. Before send the string, we use the ASCII character number 13, which is the Carnegie return as a control character, and that character will be used at the Scilab code. After, we have a delay for the program, 100 millisecond delay. This delay is used to avoid the communication errors. And let's see the Scilab code. Here, this part are the graphics window and the buttons. You can use the GUI builder to create that code with an easy way and fast way. With that variable, we control the measurement that will be plotted at the real-time graph. Here is the maximum, the minimum temperature. We can control it by that. This function, the real-time axis, is used to achieve that. Every time that I press the start measuring temperature, and then I stop the measuring temperature, then I push the stop measuring temperature button, I clear the graph. That is why I use that function. Here I control the plot data, the bounds actually, and the text. And here is the bounds for the data, for the axis, the position, and then the name, and that is the tag. That is important, the tag. Don't forget the tag. And let's speak about the base of our code. The base of our code, it's here. I open the serial communication at the default parameters, which is I use the 960 baud rates, no parity, with 8 characters. And then I read the edge time from the serial buffer one character, and if the ASCII character from the buffer is equal to 13, I read the next 7 characters, and then I convert it to double using that function. So I read the string from the buffer, and then that string I convert again to a double variable, and then I pass the data to the real-time data plot. That is our goal. And then I close the serial communication. This is my target. And when I push the stop button, I delete the real-time data plot and I recreate it again, so that's how I clear the graph. Let's see what happens if when I push the start measuring temperature. Actually, I can read my temperature. My room temperature is around 20 Celsius degree. Thanks for and that's was my goal. Thanks for watching. See you in my next video. Until then.